It is the second deadliest cancer for both men and women. More than 220,000 people diagnosed with it this year alone. Today we're going to learn what strides are being made when it comes to lung cancer.
And when you are sick, there's nothing quite like healing from the comfort of your own home. We share with you one woman's cancer surviving story and how in-home care was not only convenient, it was a necessity.
So are you afraid to go to the dentist? Not just your little one, mom, dad, grandparents. It can be you too. It's a real fear that more than half of us face, but it doesn't have to prevent you from getting the care you need. Today we're going to learn some different ways that you can rest easy when it comes to the dentist chair.
Well, there is no shortage of us looking for ways to save, and one of the biggest costs we face each month is our heating and cooling bills. Coming up, we'll show you a cost-effective, easy-to-install HVAC unit that is not only practical, it's palatable.
And have you got one of those expensive cell phones sitting in a drawer somewhere in your house because you've either cracked the screen or the battery just doesn't seem to stay charged anymore? Angie's going to let us know whether it pays to fix that device or whether it's just time for a new one.
In just a couple weeks, people will be coming from all over the world and the country to Crisfield to celebrate the crab. Coming up, a preview of the 66th annual National Hard Crab Derby. Delmarva Life starts right now.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Lisa Bryan.
I'm Jimmy Hopper. Welcome to Delmarva Life from Historic Studio D.
And we'd like to welcome our studio audience. Thanks for joining us this afternoon. You know, seeing Brian talking about the crab derby, hard crab derby, kind of makes me realize that the end of summer is near. It's kind of like that. It's here, isn't it?
With the temps we had last week, I thought it'd already gone by. But we're supposed to warm up again, so yeah. It's gonna be great. I haven't been down to the hard crab derby in a long time.
Well,
need to go back to that.
You need to go back. There you go.
Yeah, it was wonderful.
Speaking of a long time, believe it or not, it was 80 years ago this week that the epic storm of 1933 ravaged Ocean City. You remember that, Jimmy?
Wow. Really?
In August 1933, you can see the pictures, the storm
battered. That's me right there by the pole.
Battered the boardwalk and beachfront properties with massive waves, severe rain, hurricane force winds. And, you know, the streets of town were already flooded from those all that rain they had. And then I think it was on the 23rd or the 22nd, the wind started blowing and, you know, it just
took in all kinds of
things. The most historically significant change in the resort was the existence of a new inlet, which is now our old inlet, I guess you could say, at the south end of town. Now, a common misconception is that the surging ocean tides driven by the storm breached the dunes and cut the inlet, but the inlet was actually cut by the massive wall of water built up in the back bays.
So it was
risen.
Water coming out.
It was water coming out, not water coming in.
So I didn't know that.
That actually made that inlet.
How about, I mean, there was a railroad across there that got
locked out. Yeah, it connected Ocean City and Assateague.
But it made a huge difference as far as the economy.
The economy, and it also is why we have a state and national park there, because there was a contract. Now, this is something I had heard. There was a contract to build some, you know, development down there.
Right.
And because of the storm, that was all kind of.
So they cut that off.
Yeah, I'm kind of glad it happened.
Ever since then, we've been wondering, could it happen again?
Yeah.
Came close with Sandy.
Yeah.
It really did. Mm-hmm. But wow, I didn't know all that.
Never say never.
Yeah, true, true. Have you ever seen a tall ship up close? Is the Calamar Nickel considered a tall ship?
I think so, yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, there's a one that hasn't been around here recently. It's a 16th century Spanish galleon. Going to be sailing into Ocean City tomorrow. There it is. Isn't that a gorgeous ship?
It is gorgeous.
National Air, Sea, and Space Foundation is sponsoring the visit. NASSF is a nonprofit organization dedicated to enhancing science, technology, engineering, and mechanics awareness. Everybody say it together. STEM. Thank you very much. Trying to push that onto our nation's youth and, of course, the public.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm hoping that I say this right. The ship Andlucea?
That sounds
galleon?
Good to me.
I think it's what it is.
You just say it confidently.
I just say it quickly. Nobody knows.
Yeah.
It's going to be the Ocean City Bayside Pier. You can park in the municipal lot for Ocean City. It's going to be there. It arrives tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, arrives tomorrow. Goes on display Wednesday. It's going to be there through September 2nd. If you want to know more about when, where, how much, all that kind of thing, go to DelmarvaLife.com. Got all the information there for you.
Yeah, those are fun. I went on a field trip with the kids once on one of those. It was a lot of fun.
Six decks.
Yeah.
Six decks. Incredible.
Amazing. You know, speed cameras, we're seeing them all over the place. Mm-hmm. Yeah. How many, that changes the way I drive, definitely, especially in Salisbury on College Avenue. Yeah, I guess so. Yeah. But people are wondering if they're accurate.
Right.
You know, people in Salisbury are wondering if they're accurate. Apparently, there's a precedent. Because, you know, people are complaining about them in Salisbury,
right?
They
weren't calibrated.
Yeah, you know a little bit more about this than me.
Well, this I really like this because what they're saying is that if they're asking the police chief, we want records of the calibration and everything to make sure these things are working right. She said, I'll get it to you as quick as I can. I got other stuff I'm doing. Well, apparently, like you said, there is a precedent. Hagerstown had to refund over 800 speeding tickets, almost 700 refunds in Greenbelt from the company that installs and maintains these speed cameras. The Maryland Drivers Alliance is they're just trying to make sure that you honestly get charged if you really are speeding.
Right,
they're an anti-speed camera group. Mm-hmm. So they're trying to push this through, and they did Hagerstown, they did Greenbelt, and now they're saying, you know, they're in Salisbury too. So they're gonna take a look at that. As a matter of fact, the Wicomico County Council, it's on their agenda to talk about tomorrow night. And
find out
more about that.
I know if they ever take a picture of my car, which I never speed,
never.
If they ever take a picture of my car, I'm like this, you know, 10 and 2 going through there at 29 miles per hour in a 30-mile-per-hour zone.
And it's always the kids trying to say, it's not me.
Yeah.
I didn't do that.
Speaking of traffic, you can expect some in the Salisbury area in the next week or so. Princess Anne as well. Move-in day for college. There's another sign that summer is over, right?
Summer's over.
Ah.
Move-in day Thursday at SU. Now, actually, and they've got some traffic advisories out as well. More than 1,000 new students and parents coming in. Some parking areas at SU are off limits, except for the students that are moving in and some of the companies that are making deliveries. Also, I think they're opening up Wednesday at UMES for some of the local students, I believe, and the new freshman and transfer students Thursday to the returning students.
Yeah.
So be aware of that.
Just give them a little bit of space, a little, you know, they're new to the area.
Just understand it's going to take a little time.
It's going to take a little bit of time.
We'll all move on.
Hey, we want to say congratulations to Mark Flaumlecker and the crew who put on the first ever wheelchair lacrosse tournament last week in Ocean City. I don't know if you remember, a couple of weeks ago we did a story on Mark and him bringing this tournament to the area.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It was last week. It was, I think, Wednesday through Sunday. They had a great turnout. The Rolling Surf Wheelchair Division consisted of four teams from Maryland, Virginia, California, and Colorado.
Wow.
Flaumlecker coached and played on the Maryland team.
Nice. So. Way to go.
Yeah.
Good job, Mark. Bagpipes. Anybody in here a big bagpipe fan? You like it? Okay. A lot of people think just of wakes.
Yeah.
Here's something that will change your opinion of that. Take a look at the Badpiper. He claims over... Oh, wait. It gets better. This dude is clad in tattoos and leather.
Oh, and, my.
Yeah.
No, I can't unsee that, can I?
Adds a new twist to to punk rock bagpiping.
Hopefully he doesn't breathe in.
This is, yeah, really. This is actually in Fremantle, Western Australia, and he says he will do everything from weddings to receptions to business meetings, if you like.
Yeah, there you go.
That'd get your
Are you going to hire him?
Right away.
Well, a little bit later on Delmarva, like many of us live and breathe by our cell phones. I know I do, always have it handy, but it can be so easy to drop the phone, get water on it, or crack the screen. Then what do you do? We'll find out how you can repair your phone instead of replacing it.
Plus, studies show going to the dentist is the most common phobia people experience. Still, that shouldn't stop you from taking care of your teeth. We're going to learn more about steps you can take to overcome your fears.
But next, it's estimated lung cancer will kill nearly 160,000 people this year alone. We'll learn more about new lung cancer screenings that could save thousands of lives and find out if you should get one. Delmarva Life, we'll be right back.
Delmarva Life is brought to you by Sussex County Federal Credit Union, guiding you to your financial future. Peninsula Regional Medical Center, honored to serve the entire Delmarva Peninsula since 1897. Your local York and LG dealers, and State Farm Insurance. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.